Hey guys, welcome to Electrofun. In my previous video, I have started with a topic called convolution, and this is the continuation of that. Now we have seen a graphic analytical convolution in my previous video. In this video, we will see what is linear convolution. This topic comes under FIR, which is finite impulse response. So let's get started. I'll directly move on with the sum so that it is very easy for you to understand what is the concept and topic all about. Determine output y of n if x of n is equal to 8421.5 and h of n is equal to 0.5122. Now this is the one of the simplest convolution, I feel so. The rest of them are also not that tough. Now let's understand what exactly this means to obtain solution, to obtain output y of n, we use convolution summation, which is given by y of n is x of n into h of n, which is given by k is minus infinity to plus infinity x of k, by the definition which we have seen before. Now let's understand what this means. We have a train of impulse x of n, some values, and h of n. Now what this arrow means, it means this is the origin. It means n is 0 over here. This is n 1, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 1, plus 2, plus 1 and 2. So this is the representation from which we understand where the origin of output will be, and it is necessary. Now let's just go tabular format, x of n over here and h of n over here. This is 0.5, 1, 2 and 4. Over here it is 8, then 4, 2, 1 and 0.5. I'll just draw a box. The arrow for h of n is here, and for x of n it is over here. Now what you need to do is, we just need to multiply two of the signals, which means 8 into 0.5, it will be 4, 4 into 0.5, it will be 2, over here it will be 1. I'm understanding, I'm just multiplying. If I'm over here, it means this multiplied by this, this multiplied by this, this multiplied by this, 1 multiplied by 0.5. So it will be 0.5, 0.5 multiplied by 0.5, it will be 0.25. Similarly, 8 into 1, 8, 4, 2, 1 and 0.5. 8 into 2, 16, 8, 4, 2 and 0.5 into 2, it will be 1. Then 8 into 4, 32, 4, 16, 8, 4, 2. So this is the way you fill the table by multiplying two signals corresponding values. Now what we need to do is, the length of x, the elements present 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it will be 5. The length of h, it is 4. Now, the length of y is given by lx plus lh minus 1, which means this is the way you check that if whatever you have done is right or no. 4 plus 5 plus 4, 9 minus 1, which will be 8. So, this will be the total number of elements present in output. So, we'll just write y of n over here. So, how you can get that output? What you need to do over here is we need to add in cross. It means this way. The first element will be 4. Then 8 plus 2. It will be 10. I will just use a different color pen. Let's see so that you can understand it in a better way. Yeah. So I'm just adding the elements in cross. As you can see over here. Then it is 16, 4, and 1, which is 21. Then 32, 8, 2, and 0.5, 40, 42, 42.5. After that, this you are adding the diagonal elements 20, 21, 21.25. Now you can see the arrow is over here and the next arrow is over here. That means this diagonal is my origin. So arrow will be over here. You're understanding it, right? The arrow for x of n is here and for h of n it is here. It meets over here at 1. So this diagonal elements when you add, that will be the origin, which means n is 0 over. Then continuing the addition. 10, 10.5, 5, and the last will be 2. So this is my output. Now we have seen there will be 8 elements. So let's just check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is the way you justify the number of elements present by x of n and h of n and the origin defined by them. So this is all about the linear convolution. I hope you have understood this topic. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section below. I'll answer all of them. Till then, like my video, share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.